Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel Simplified Basic Concepts. In this video, I'll start with Maslow's Need Hierarchy Theory. In my previous video, I spoke about motivation theory and the types of motivation theory. So this is one of the content theories of motivation. So let's begin with the contents. In this video, I'll talk about introduction to the Maslow's Need Hierarchy Theory. Then we'll move to Maslow's Pyramid. And I'll also explain needs, which are explained in Maslow's pyramid, then the implications of Maslow's hierarchy of needs, and finally, the limitation of this theory. So let's begin with the introduction. Maslow's hierarchy of needs is a theory in psychology proposed by Abraham Maslow in his 1943 paper, which was a theory of human motivation. This theory remains valid till today for understanding human motivation, management training, and personal development. This theory is based on assumption that there is a hierarchical level of needs, which Maslow explained in pyramid form. This theory is a 5-tier model of human needs. So by this, we get an idea that first of all, Maslow's need hierarchy theory is a content theory of motivation. The content theory of motivation says that the reason, the need for a motivation of an individual should be explained. So Maslow too explains the need which motivates an individual. He also assumes that there is not one but hierarchy of needs which an individual has to satisfy. Now this hierarchy of needs is a very strict hierarchy as per Maslow, because he says that till the time the lower order need in the hierarchy is not satisfied, an individual cannot move up in the ladder. So now let's see what's Maslow's pyramid. So this is Maslow's pyramid. It shows the 5 level of needs, which are physiological needs. This is the lowest order need and needs to be satisfied first or initially by an individual. Then second in the ladder is safety needs. The third in the pyramid is social needs. Then comes esteem needs and finally self-actualization needs. As per Maslow, physiological needs and safety needs are lower order needs. And the rest 3, that is social needs, esteem needs, self-actualization needs, are higher order needs. Now he also clubbed these needs into basic needs, psychological needs, and self-fulfillment needs. He said physiological needs and safety needs, which are lower order needs, can also be said as basic needs. And social needs and esteem needs are psychological needs. And finally, self-actualization needs come in the category of self-fulfillment needs. Now here, Maslow speaks about the 5 level of needs. He says that till the time an individual doesn't satisfy his lower order need, he cannot move up in the ladder of need satisfaction. So first an individual needs to satisfy his physiological needs, then only he will move up for satisfaction of his safety needs, and then he'll move on in the ladder till the time his self-actualization needs are fulfilled. Now what are physiological needs? These are needs for basic amenities of life. Physiological needs include food, water, clothing, sleep, air, and shelter. So the physiological needs are those needs which are very important for an individual for survival. Now, without these needs, an individual cannot survive in a society. So a human being who exists will first only tend to satisfy these needs, then only he will move up in the ladder of need satisfaction. Now the second comes security and safety needs. If a person feels unsafe in an environment, he will first try to find safety before moving ahead in the need ladder. It includes physical, environmental, emotional, safety, and protection. Now, some of the basic security and safety needs are job security, personal security, health security, law and order. Now, this we all know, though Maslow has explained this in his pyramid, but we all know that till the time we don't feel safe in an environment, we will always be very scared. So, as per Maslow, when the physiological needs are being satisfied, that is the basic need for survival is being satisfied, the second need which an individual will tend to satisfy is need for safety, because everybody wants to live in a society, in an organization, in an environment which is safe for him and his family. Now, this so basic security and safety needs talk about security in totality, that is about the job security, about a person's security in an environment where he lives, about the health security, and also about the law and order of the place where he is living. Now, when these two needs are satisfied, these two are the basic needs, the lower order needs, which are very important for an individual. So when these two needs are satisfied, the individual will move to the third need, which is social need. The third need is social needs. These are the needs for belongingness, love, affection, for relationship with family and friends. At this level, the need for emotional relationships drives human behavior. This need includes social groups, belongingness, and friendship. So the third in the need ladder, in the pyramid of Maslow's need hierarchy theory, is social needs. By social needs, Maslow means the need where an individual wants to socialize, wants to meet, wants to have a relationship among his people, among the people who are present in his surrounding, with his colleagues, co-workers, superiors, seniors, or where a society in which he is living, he wants to have a group. Now, this is one strong emotional need which needs to be satisfied, because this at times drives human behavior. At times, these needs are so powerful that an individual takes decision based on satisfaction of these needs. Now, the fourth need is esteem needs. At this level in Maslow's hierarchy is need for appreciation and respect, which is esteem needs. Here, individual begins to develop positive feelings of self-worth and want to have their efforts recognized. Now, the esteem needs are of two types. Internal esteem needs that originates from within an individual, and the other one is external esteem needs. Now, the internal self-esteem is self-respect, confidence, competence, achievement, and freedom. Now, these things originates within an individual, and the external esteem needs are recognition, respect, which an individual expects from other people. That is, when an individual wants to satisfy his external esteem needs, he expects recognition and respect for himself. He expects recognition for the work he has done, for the respect he has. And the final one is self-actualization need. It's said that what a man can be, he must be. A musician must make music. A poet must write. And an artist must paint if he wants to be ultimately happy. It is described as reaching one's own full potential by doing the best they are capable of doing. Now, this self-actualization need here, an individual doesn't expect anything. He just wants to reach his full potential. He wants to explore his potential and do things accordingly. He doesn't expect money or other materialistic things. The things which he expects is need for growth, utilizing and developing his own talents and abilities, self-contentment, and giving creativity, right? So these are the things which an individual expects when he is at the highest level of his need satisfaction. Now let's see what are the implications of Maslow's hierarchy of needs theory. Now we have seen that these are the five needs of Maslow's hierarchy. Now what should a manager do to satisfy these needs of an individual? When we talk about physiological needs, so it can be free lunches, breaks and eating opportunities which can be provided to the employee in organization. The safety needs can be hygienic work environment, retirement benefits. When we talk about social needs, it can be socializing after work, encouraging teamwork. Esteem needs can be perks, bonus, giving higher job rank to the individual. And finally, the self-actualization needs can be satisfied by freedom to innovate, giving business cards, because by these things an individual's self-actualization needs will be satisfied. And finally, let's see what are the limitations of Maslow's need hierarchy theory. Now this theory assumes that all people experience needs in the same order, ignoring cultural and individual differences. It is difficult for managers to identify the need level for employees. That is, at times it is very hard for managers to identify at which level an employee is and what type of need he is having. So he doesn't have any idea what type of things should be provided to him so that the employee's needs get satisfied. Third is, this theory is not empirically supported. Maslow restricted the number of self-actualized people experimented in his theory. And finally, the basic needs always may not be satisfied to acknowledge higher order needs. And a starving artist is an example of it. So these were the limitations of Maslow's need hierarchy theory. With this, we come to the end of this topic, Maslow's need hierarchy theory. And in my next video, I'll cover another content theory of motivation, which is Hertzberg's two-factor theory. Thank you.